Hey guys, today we are checking out Razer's Chroma Light Strip Kit. And as you know, I am a pretty massive fan of lighting up my surroundings with cool and colorful lights. So obviously I was super hyped when Razer reached out to me to test these out for their product launch. In this video, I wanted to go over a quick setup and just kind of show you guys some of the things it can do. So let me know if you guys have any questions down below in regards to this product. Would you kindly subscribe, as we are also making a push for 5,000 subscribers. So every sub and like helps. So if you guys do find this video informative, make sure you hit the like button. I do appreciate your guys' support. To start off the unboxing, I do have to say that Razer always packages their products in such a nice way. I'm not sure if that's a little bit too geeky of me to say, or does anybody else pay attention to these things? In the box, you'll get a few things. 250 centimeter light strips, as well as a 100 centimeter light strip, which have this sort of blurred acrylic look to them and feel rubbery to the touch. You have the power adapter, 3 controller, 2 LED strip connector cables, 2 double-sided adhesive tape packs, 15 mounting brackets, 3 LED strip protector clips, a USB wireless transceiver, your Razer Chroma wireless ARGB controller, and 15 bracket adhesive tapes. Pretty much everything you will need to properly set these lights up. Okay, to set them up, it's fairly simple. You will first grab your controller hub and plug it into the power supply. Then attach the 3 controller to light strip connectors and plug them into their inputs. Make sure they're correctly aligned with the holes, as you want to be careful not to bend them. Okay, you're now going to attach the light strips to the controller hub. The side with the little tag will be the one that goes into the hub. As you can see, mine lit up after I pressed my mouse. That's because I have Razer Synapse downloaded onto my computer and I use the software to turn it on. The software recognized my light strip because I plugged in the Bluetooth that came with the lights into my PC. So if yours don't come on, don't worry, I'll show you guys how to set them up. It's actually pretty easy. First, you want to make sure to plug in your Bluetooth adapter into the PC. Next, open up Synapse, and if it doesn't automatically show up on your screen like mine, don't worry. All you have to do is press the middle button on the controller hub itself and hold it. That will actually turn on the device and link it via the Bluetooth connection. Once the controller hub is shown on Synapse, make sure you press the little power button, as it will turn the lights on and off. If you're having any sort of issues with a strip not showing up, or maybe it's just not lighting up, if you press the little arrow that's going in a circular motion, that will refresh your controller hub. For me, that usually has troubleshooted any sort of issues I was having. With these light strips, you don't actually need Razer Synapse to use them, but I highly recommend using Synapse, as it will give you a huge range of customization. You can control your lights via the controller. The middle button will turn the lights on and off. The button on the left will dim down your lights until they turn off, and the one on the right will make your lights brighter. So the way I wanted to set these up were to run them along the corner of my room, but I wasn't necessarily sure if you were able to connect them to each other to make a long one. Turns out that you can't. So I was kind of having a bit of an issue when I was trying to set them up all together, and I don't know, you might as well, but if you follow my instructions, you will be able to connect them with each other just fine. I just needed to use one port on my controller hub, so I chose hub 1. I plugged in an LED to light strip connector and then attached my light strips to it. First, I did the 2 smaller ones, and lastly, I did the longer one. I then went on Synapse, I made sure to refresh my hub, and on the LEDs box, I changed it to 120. So the longer strip has 60 individual LEDs, and the shorter ones have 30 individual LEDs. That would be a total combined of 120. I then went into my Chroma Studio, set up my colors, and here you can set them up to whatever you pick. That's the fun part about Razer's Synapse. I then hit save, and then my strips were working perfectly. Okay, now for the mounting part. I wanted to mount these as the kit came with a bunch of mounting gear, and I wanted to test out how well it would hold up. That way I could come back down the line and do a follow-up review for you guys in the future, and mainly just basically to see if these really are worth the price. So I picked the right corner of my room to set them up, as I thought it would look pretty cool actually. I used the double-sided tape and the brackets that it came with to mount the light strips in place. I then ran them up along my wall and around the corner of my ceiling. These strips are actually pretty flexible, and they curved around the corner of my ceiling very smoothly. After I had the strips in place, I plugged them into my controller hub and then I turned them on. From first sight, I really love how they came out, and within the kit, I didn't really realize it before, but it actually has a pretty good amount of length. The possibilities are pretty varied, and I can't wait to see how people get creative with their strips. It honestly does make me want to get more to get really crazy with them. So the finished product came out looking awesome. I think picking the right corner was a good idea, as it really helps brighten up the room and give it more of a kick. The lights were easy to set up out of the box, easy to mount, and they are incredibly bright. They also shine very smoothly as well. The lights sync seamlessly with Razer Synapse and possibly offer the widest range of customization you can have with any RGB product. I will say, one thing that I'm not the biggest fan of is probably the way these lights connect to each other. The cable in between them just looks sort of ugly, and splitting the lights just doesn't look good in my opinion. If they continuously ran up the wall, I think it would create a better look and feel overall. It's not a deal breaker or something that will turn me away from purchasing these lights myself, but what I'm thinking is that maybe in the future they can make it so they attach to each other without having some sort of cable in between them. Maybe each end can sort of slide into each other, creating a smoother connection that isn't visible. And for the corners, it could be a piece that's made specifically for corners. I'm just saying, these are things that you see from other products in the market today, and I think Razer should be adapting these features as well. So let me know what you guys think about these lights, and if you have any questions, please make sure to drop them down below. Subscribe to the channel and like the video for a follow-up review on these lights, as I do want to come back to them in a few months and see exactly how they're holding up. With that said, take care, be safe, and I'll definitely catch you guys on the next one. Peace.